7 Google Ads mistakes to avoid at all costs. You guys simply can't afford to be doing these mistakes because they will eat up your budget, they will drastically reduce your conversions, and overall, you will have a very, very bad experience with Google Ads if you make these mistakes. So stay tuned and watch to the end of the video as I go over all these 7 mistakes you could do with Google Ads and how to avoid them. Let's get straight into it. The first mistake that many people do with Google Ads is not setting up conversion tracking. Guys, the whole point of Google Ads or any of this sort of marketing is to get conversions, whether it's leads or sales. So you absolutely, absolutely, guys, you have to set up conversion tracking. If you click on tools and settings here, click on conversions, you should be able to follow the steps here and set up your conversion tracking. Now, I do have a separate video for that. So I do suggest that you follow through and do what I say in that video because, guys, cost per click, clicks, impressions, you know, top impression share, none of that matters if you aren't getting conversions. So absolutely, guys, the number one thing you should do if you start off with Google Ads is set up conversion tracking. And this is just something that I really don't see a lot of people do. Moving on to the number 2 Google Ad mistake to avoid at all costs is using broad match keywords. Guys, broad match keywords are just way too broad. So just to show you an example, if we go into tools and settings, go to keyword planner here, click on discover new keywords, and let's say I want to type in lose weight fast, and we're gonna target, let's say, Canada and United States. We're gonna click save. Pretty much all of these search results that you see here, all of these keyword ideas, could be search terms that people could be typing in to see your ad, to trigger a keyword that you will be paying for. So let's look at 500 different ideas. So for example, let's suppose you offer a pill or a product or a blog or something like that to help people lose weight fast. So let's take a look at this here. All of these could potentially trigger your ad to show up. So for example, 30-day juice fast weight loss result. If you were not selling a juice, this won't be applicable to you. Then you see exercise. You see best exercise to lose belly fat. So this is also where this targeting comes in because you have to differentiate. Are you promoting an exercise or are you promoting a sort of pill or a weight loss product, right? 18-6 intermittent fasting results. So this isn't exactly what you're offering. You're offering to lose weight fast for this example, and people are typing in 18-6 intermittent fasting results, which could trigger your ad to show up. Again, not something you want. Eating one meal a day for a month, that could be irrelevant to what you're doing. So all of these, pretty much all of these, guys, no matter how relevant or irrelevant, if you're using broad match keywords, could trigger your keywords and your ads to show up, which means you're just gonna be spending money that much faster. So I do suggest that you guys use exact or phrase match keywords to avoid these irrelevant searches. So tied to that, moving on to mistake number 3 to avoid is not using negative keywords. So whether you guys are using phrase, broad, or exact match keywords, you still have to use negative keywords. And this is something I see that people aren't doing very often. So if you come over here, you come into negative keywords, this is how you can add negative keywords. And just to give you an idea of why this is so useful, if you click on the search terms and see what people are actually typing in, for example, for this campaign to trigger my ads to show up, you will see phrases such as this. Look at this, free Google marketing course. And I paid $5 for this click, guys, whereas my courses aren't free, right? People have to pay. And so here, I paid $5 for this. Now, I didn't spend much on this entire campaign. I spent only $88. So imagine if I'm spending hundreds of dollars or thousands of dollars, how much of that will go towards these bad searches, these irrelevant searches. So what you want to do is you want to pick out the words that aren't relevant to what you're offering, and then head over into keywords here and then click on negative keywords, and then you want to add the negative keywords that aren't relevant to your search terms, like I did over here with free. I do have another video explaining how to use negative keywords and the different negative keyword match types, so make sure to check that video out as well. And before we continue, guys, if you are finding value in this video, if you want to see more tips, tricks, techniques for Google Ads or just in general how to make money online, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe. Hit the notification bell icon so that you stay tuned for more updates and more videos where I share things like this so you guys can make money online or save money, increase conversions, things like that. That being said, let's move on to the mistake number four you guys have to avoid, and that is meshing your search campaigns and display campaigns. You definitely don't want to do that. So when you first create your campaign, when you're in the campaign creation process, you might see a screen that looks like this. It might be on the left, might be on the right, might be at the top, might be at the bottom, but it will look like this, where you will have the option to select search or display. And usually Google has by default this display network on, and you don't want to do that. You want to separate out your display and your search campaigns because they're two completely separate beasts, guys. You're showing ads to people specifically searching for what it is you are selling, for what it is you're offering using keywords. Display ads are more of disruptive advertising. You're gonna be showing these ads on different websites, different YouTube channels, not something that people are searching for. So it's a completely different beast, requires completely different resources. So I would suggest if you do want to do display advertising, you separate these out and you create two separate campaigns, one for search, one for display. I also have a video showing you exactly how to create a display campaign in as little as 5 minutes. You can take a look at that video, but I don't suggest putting them together because your budget will be expended very, very quickly if you put the two together. Speaking of budget being expended too quickly, one of the mistakes I do see people do is if they are seeing some sales, some conversions, I notice that people tend to increase the budget a little too fast, too soon. And if you guys have done Facebook advertising at all, you know that that's a big no-no. It seems to screw up the algorithms. And if you increase the budget too fast, what happens is Google then tries to find as many customers as possible, even if they aren't ideal for your audience, for your product. And so what's going to happen is Google will eat up your new budget very, very quickly, and your conversions will actually go down. So you don't want to do that. So what you guys want to do instead is slowly increase your budget 15, 20, maximum 30% of your current budget every few days, let's say every 3 to 4 days. So here, if our campaign budget, let's go to this campaign, looking for the campaigns tab here. Let's see what our campaign budget is. Give it a second to load there. So here the campaign budget, for example, for the search campaign is $62. So what you wanna do is do the math, pull out your calculator and do 62.10 times, let's say 1.20. So your new budget, what you want to set it to, if you are scaling and you want to see more conversions, you can set your budget to $74.52. And that's really as high as you should go every 4 days, because otherwise your budget will be expended and eaten up by Google way too fast. And if you guys do want to scale and you're looking for scaling best practices, I do have a video on that as well that you can take a look and see in more detail. So then moving on to mistake number six to avoid is not using ad extensions. Guys, ad extensions are so easy, yet they're so effective. They can take you as little as 5 minutes to set up and you're set, but your CTRs, your clicks will drastically go up. So for example, site link extensions here, you can add call out extensions, structured snippet extensions. So site link extensions, if you go to Google, you type anything in, let's say learn guitar, site link extensions will look like this. So they are additional kind of, you can say, table of contents underneath your ad that people can click on that get attention. And look at this, guys, this ad with these extensions takes up the space of about 2 or 3 ads. Can you imagine? Can you imagine how much more visible this ad is? That's absolutely insane. The chances of somebody clicking on this ad is just so much higher than any of these, because this is the biggest thing by far that people see on this page. You can also utilize other extensions. There are callout extensions, structured snippet extensions, price extensions, promotion extensions, any of that. I do cover that in detail in my Google Ads training course, but they look something like this. You can see here, and they just make your ad look much, much bigger. Why not add them, guys? There's no reason not to add them. They make your ad stand out so much more and get so much more attention that will drastically increase your CTRs, increase your clicks, relevant clicks, and get you higher conversions. And last but not least, Google Ads mistake to avoid at all costs, number 7, is not split testing enough, guys. So what I see is a lot of people just have one ad variation or just have one country or things like that. And what you want to do is you want to constantly be testing, because if you're spending money on this, you might as well see how different variations perform so that you can then spend money on the one that performs better. Because if you're spending, let's say here, $62 a day on only one ad, you might as well get data, right? You might as well get data to determine what works and what doesn't for those $60. So what you want to do is what I have here. For example, I have some ad variations. Over here, I have different headlines. If you're doing display ads, you can have different images, you can have different headlines, things like that, and you can test. At least have 2 total ads, for example, running at any time so that you can see which one does better. However, you don't want to make too many ad variations, because if you're not spending thousands or tens of thousands or millions of dollars, not all of your ad variations will actually get those clicks, right? So you want to make sure you have enough ad variations, 2 to 3 total ads maximum, just so that you have enough clicks for each one, for each variation, to see how each one performs. And that is it, guys. So these are the 7 Google ad mistakes you should avoid at all costs. If you guys enjoyed this content, I do invite you to check out my website at ivanmana.com, where I have a lot of free resources, as well as very detailed, very comprehensive training courses, such as Google Ads Mastery or Google Ads Retargeting, which goes into great detail for campaign creation process and how to successfully create and optimize your campaigns. That is all for this video. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next one.